Assalamualaikum. Good afternoon. Can you hear me?
Waalaikumsalam. Dokter, we can hear you.
Yes, dokter. Okay.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alamin. Salatu wassalamu ala sayyidina Muhammadin ashrafil anbiya mursalin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. So, without any further ado, I will go to the chapter 1, Introduction to Control System. Okay. So, basically, today, my lecture, the content of my lecture is given in the outline as shown in the Zoom slide. And I already give three files to you, my slide, my book chapter, and tutorial one. So the content for today's lecture will be on control system basic, some history of control system configuration, okay, examples of control system, analysis and design objective, and simulation software in control MATLAB. So all of you has installed MATLAB in your laptop? Zakari, Ahmed? Tak ada.
No, doctor, I didn't install it.
Install MATLAB in your laptop?
No, but I will install it later to class.
As soon as possible.
Okay.
And Rita, have you installed MATLAB in your laptop?
I still haven't installed it, but I will try to install it by today.
As soon as possible. Okay. Abdul Rahman Ludin?
Yes, doctor.
Have you installed MATLAB?
Not yet, but in progress now.
In progress now. Okay, so please install MATLAB using campus wide license of UTM. So you go to myutm.my using your ASIC identity, and then you find a software for download, and there is a MATLAB for students to use. UTM already subscribed the license for MATLAB wide campus 2021 version. The price is 300,000 RM. Okay, so please use the facilities as soon as possible. So control system basic, basically we are talking about something we can control, a technique. Okay, so I give you two pictures. One is the, hurricane. Okay, hurricane, or in Malay, puting beliung, and one is the Malaysian national carrier, air carrier, which is known as MAS. Okay, so we have two system. Okay, what is the different? What is the common things? Okay, in these two system, the common things that share between these two pictures is both are very highly complicated system, okay? Very complicated. And if you want to derive the mathematical model, so it will very tough, okay? And very highly complicated. And both are transporting, okay? From one point to another, okay? Over a long distance. For example, this hurricane will transport all the house, all the people, all the roof, all the trees, okay, inside this white hurricane, and there will be some randomly carried to another point. While in this system, you transport the people from one point to another. For example, from KL to London, which is 13 hours, okay? When I did my master's and PhD in 1990s, late 1990s, the flight from KL to London, Boeing 747, took 13 hours, 13 jam, okay, direct flight from KL to London. But if the difference between these two picture is this one, okay, this one is uncontrollable. You cannot control because this is the mother nature. But this one, the picture below here, the aeroplane, you can control. Okay, there is a pilot in front of it, and the aeroplane is controlled by the pilot and autopilot by computer control. Okay, they set the location like Google Map or like Waze. The target. Okay, first is from your KL, and then destination is London. So you can just start and the aeroplane will take off, okay, and bring the people from KL to London. So that what we call as the hidden technology that you meet every day. On top of it, beside that, we also have a control system which is widely used and present in our daily life. Okay, this is one of the pictures at the PTP Malaysia, which is the second port of Johor. The first port of Johor is at Pasir Gudang. The second part of port of Johor is at PTP, okay, near UTM. Okay, so you can see there a lot of crane. Okay, a lot of crane that carry the container. Okay, this is the container. And this is a crane. They are using a highly performance magnet, okay, to bring the crane, the imported crane, from one point to another, from the ship to the port, and the port to the lorry, to be carried out to the destinations. And this one is one of our pride in our School of Electrical Engineering, which is known as Robocon robot. Okay, so for this year, UTM and the School of Electrical Engineering is the champion and the runners up for a national level of Robocon. Okay, so our school is one of the famous group in Robocon. Besides that, we also have a control system in washing machines, in radio antenna, in rocket missiles, robots, and the simple one is a room air condition in your house. So what is a control system? Control systems provides output and in or response for a given input or stimulus. Okay, so we have to give input. Okay, here, this is the input, or we call it as a stimulus, or so simply known as the desired response. And there is an output, okay, response, which is the actual response. For example, when you are in the first year of your study, you went to our school building at B19A, there is a lift, okay, to access to room number one, level number one, level number two, three and four, okay. So simply you just enter the number of the levels by pressing the lift, then the elevator will bring you to the required levels that you want. So this system is known as the desired level, is known as the input, and the destination level is the output, and the elevator level is the control variable. Okay, either go to level 1, 2, 3, or 4. So in general, control system block diagram is shown here. Okay, we have two subsystems, which is one is the controller, second one is the actuator, and the third one is the plant or the process. we have an input on your left, which is the desired output, or known as a set point. And we have the output signals, which is the actual response. So controller will not discuss in this subject. It will discuss in subject S E E E 3143, which is next semester. In order to study control system design, you must pass this subject first, system modeling and analysis. Okay, so it's a prerequisite subject. So we just, in this subject, we just learn modeling, basic control, representation, and so on. And then actuator. So you must have actuator, which is consists of a valve and a motor. Okay, so valve can be on off, or varying valve, or motor. It can be a DC motor or AC motor. So AC motor is applied in many house appliances. For example, a blender, okay, you blend something to cook something. And then it also available in the fan, ceiling fan, have using a DC motor. Okay, what else? Alarm, car alarm, okay, central locking is using a DC motor. To flip a mirror of a car, also using a DC motor. Wiper of a car, also using a DC motor. So a lot of things. And AC motor also applied in this control system, where it will be implement in power electronics system. Okay, usually for EV, electric vehicle. So for EV, we have to use AC motor instead of DC motor. So examples of control system is applying in a position control system, okay, where it involved in robot arm, crane system, elevator, and satellite tracking. Speed control, which is the speed of airplane, washing machine, okay, during washing and during spin, we have two different speed. Climbing robot, okay, also in the speed control. And then the temperature control, which is the air condition, heater, and furnace. Okay, so nowadays we have a new appliance, kitchen appliance, which is many of the young people like to use it. We call it as an air fryer. Okay, air fryer, where you don't use oil anymore to fry something, to fry chicken or to fry anything. You just use the air fryer to fry chicken or fish or even French fries, okay, which is very healthy because less oil, okay, and easy to maintain. And then furnace is one of the temperature control. So in air fryer, you can set the heater, you can set the temperature 200 Celsius or 250 Celsius, different, depend on the model that you use. Then we also have a level control, okay, which is for liquid, level of liquid and water, especially in a water tank, oil tank, okay, in the toilet tank also have a level control. And then the vibration control, which is this one is more towards machine vibrations, car suspension, motorbike suspension, road bike suspension, mountain bike suspension, all are using vibration control. Advantage of using a control system is it will help human in daily operating life. Okay, for example, for power amplifications, you want to move containers, big containers, 20 footer or 40 footer from the ship to the lorry or to the warehouse. So we have to use the crane, OK? okay, the green crane, okay, then carry from the container from the ship to the warehouse or to the lorry. For remote control, also we need a control system in controlling the movement of robots working, especially in the car manufacturing, contaminated area where you have a highly radiated surface or area, okay, where human presence should be avoided. Then for convenience of input form, sample for temperature control of aircon, where usually when we go to sleep, we set the temperature at 27 Celsius for 2 hours. So when we start to sleep from 12 to 2 o'clock, the aircon will on. After 2 a.m., the aircon will off because we set it for 2 hours. And then for compensation for disturbance, for example, for maintaining antenna positions in the present of strong wind. Okay, so this is the UHV antenna, UHF antenna, ultra high frequency, where you get TV3, TV1, and so on. But now, this antenna can also be applied under DTV, digital TV. Okay, so if you stay in the hostel, you install this antenna, you can get a Singapore channel using DTV, provided you are using a new TV. Okay, you can get a DTV, a Singapore channel, a 6 Singapore channel for free, because it's considered as overflow informations. Or maybe you have a strong budget, then you go for Astro, which is using a satellite TV. Okay. Any question? Muaz. Papa. Muaz.
Ya, ada.
Ada soalan?
Setakat ni tak ada lagi. Sihat, alhamdulillah.
Balkis. Assalamualaikum.
Waalaikumsalam, doktor.
Apa khabar?
Sihat.
Any question, Balkis? After 20 minutes talk.
Tak ada lagi setakat ni. Sebab baru intro.
Clear?
Clear.
Yeah. Nur Aina.
saya ada soalan.
Siapa tu?
Muaz.
Tadi kata tak ada.
Baru teringat. Tadi terfikir tak?
Okay. Silakan.
untuk control system, kita akan study pasal gantry crane ke?
Gantry crane. Purposely in the lecture, tidak, no. But maybe in case study, maybe.
Gantry
crane. Case study, assignment.
Cuma kenapa kita pilih gantry crane? Sebab saya daripada elektronik kan, jadi saya rasa macam gantry crane tu lebih kepada elektrik.
So the topic will be different because section 3 and 4 majority is SEEE.
Oh, elektrik.
Section 3 and 4. Okay. Jadi Muaz is special. SEEL. SEEL.
Okay. I wrong seal the section.
Actually no section lah. Section SEEL usually section 6, 7 and 8.
Kalau elektrik bukan gantry, dia akan belajar apa, doktor?
Kalau elektrik for modeling is general. Modeling is general because this subject is general. In next semester for design, maybe it will be different according to the electrical or electronic or mechatronic.
Okay,
we proceed for history of control system 1.2. So this is a history of control system 1900 to 2000, where the early control system is based on the Al Jazari water clock. Okay, so 1206. Okay, steam pressure and temperature control system is already exist in 1680s. Then speed control invent in 1745. Then this control system need to be stable. Okay, stable meaning no problem during operation. Okay, so for example, for the aeroplane, if the aeroplane is set from KL to London, so they take off after 13 hours, landing at London safely. So that one we call the system of the aeroplane is stable. But if the system is not stable for aeroplane, take off from Kuala Lumpur, destination Shanghai, China. So, okay, after 2 hours take off at the Vietnam Sea, the aeroplane suddenly lost from the radar. Okay, until now we don't know where the MH173, I forgot the number. Okay, lost. KL to Shanghai, that one is 2013 or something. Okay, so the aeroplane lost in action. So all the crews, all the passengers, including a pilot, cannot be detected. Okay, so that is the sample of unstable aeroplane. Maybe the engine problem, maybe being hijacked, or maybe loss in the space is a mystery. Okay, so considered as a unstable. So that's why Ralph Lewis come with a theory for the stability theories, and the Lyapunov for non-linear system at 1892. Then in 20th century, we go for automatic ship steering. Okay, PID controller was invented in 1920s. And feedback control system technique in 1930s, and Ruud Lucas boat Nyquist in 1948. Okay, and nowadays contemporary widespread application including navigation, entertainment, smart home, military, space application, chemical process, nano system also applied control system, including the new one, Internet of Things. Okay, Internet of Things, where first you have three main component of Internet of Things. First one is the sensor to detect the signal. Second one is the, what do you call that, the communication board. Okay, and then the third one is the process. Okay, so you can control, you can see, you can measure the control system via internet. Okay, so this is the Al Jazari elephant clock. Okay, so you can see the structures. Okay, of the early clock, which is the Muslims' origin, is invented by the Muslim persons. Okay. This Al Jazari clock is a highly creative and innovative engineering. Okay, crowning achievement was converting a rotational motion to linear, crucial pumps, engines, and many others. So he is known as the father of robotics, Al Jazari, who invented this elephant clock. But now we have a lot of applications. Okay. Refrigerator, hot water shower, washing machine, aircon, remote control. This one is iron. So nowadays we have a very sophisticated iron using a steam. Okay, where there is a reservoir under the iron. Okay, so you can use that iron when you forgot to switch off the switch, so it will automatically off After 2 minutes, not moving, which is very good in innovation and creativity. Then we can see in aeroplane and in high speed train, especially in Japan and Korea. Okay, this is the petrochemical industry also using control system, robotics. Okay, for the waiters. Okay, in medical system. Okay, and in research, high tech research. So we have two types of control. One is the manual control. Okay, so manual control meaning it's controlled by us, by human. Okay, human aided control. Okay, operator constantly observe the deviations of the measurements and make correction as necessary. Okay, so this is the human. Okay. Or maybe technician, or maybe technical assistant, or maybe an engineer, which is control the level of the liquid in the tank. Okay, so when it reaches the maximum, we close the valve by hand. Okay, to avoid overflow. Okay, if not, the water will increase and overflow. Okay, outside the tank. So this kind of technique is not consistent. You have hundreds of variables to control. And as a human, we are not running out of doing mistakes, okay? So we are human, we have always make mistakes. Sometimes we forgot, sometimes we are not in purpose, so we can make a careless mistake. So to replace this drawback of manual control, we introduce automatic control by replacing human with machine. So nowadays, machines is using computers, okay, or using handphone to implement the control of the plant, where you measurement still using hardware, which is sensors and transducers, and decisions is from using a computer. And the control actions is using the actuators, which is the valve or the motor. Okay, actuators is something that moving. Okay, actuators is a device that moving, that convert electric signal to mechanical signal. Okay, for example, motor rotating, valve moving. Okay, forward, backward, forward, backward. That is actuators. Okay, 1.3, control system configurations. Right, Muhammad Isma. Muhammad Isma. Tak datang?
Yes, Ata.
Okay. Any question?
No, so far, Ata. Not yet.
Isma, if you have no question, I have questions. My question is, what is the difference between sensors and actuators? Hello, Isma. Isma. Ada. Ada. Isma. Ada. Najwa.
Yeah, doctor.
What is the difference between sensors and actuators?
Sensors is the device that can detect something. For actuators is device that moving.
Kurang tepat. Muhammad Farhan, what is the difference between sensors and actuators? Farhan, tak datang? Tak datang. Farhan tak datang? Ada. Ada? Tak datang eh? Nur Aina? Nur Aina,
Najira? Yes, I am.
I have a question for you. What is the difference between sensors and actuators?
I think sensors is for detection, like temperature, and for actuators is something device that moving, like motor.
Okay, tak berapa tepat sama macam Najwa. So the answer is, what is the difference between sensors and actuators? Okay, the answer is sensors is a device that detect physical signal and convert it to electrical signal. For example, thermocouple. Thermocouple is a sensor that detect physical signal. What is physical signal? Temperature. Okay, and then convert the temperature into electrical signal, which is voltage or current. Actuators pula is a device that input is electrical signal. And then the output signal of actuators is mechanical signal. So electric signals, input of actuators usually in current or in voltage. And then the output is the mechanical signal, which is the movement, rotation, displacement. Okay. Understand? Understand?
Yes, doctor.
Yes, doctor.
Next. Control system configurations. So usually configuration of control system consists of two types. One is open loop and the other one is closed loop. Okay, so what is open loop? Open loop is the output signal of the open loop control system is not feedback to influence the control system, meaning that it is just one way. Okay, one way. So the system that work based on time open loop control system with disturbance, noise, the desired response cannot be achieved. So actual or desired response output. So meaning that disturbance is very easy to enter the open loop control system. So this will make the results not accurate. Okay, and cannot be reliable. Okay, so this is the example of open loop control system where you have the input, which is physical signal detect by the sensor. So this is sensor, okay, or transducer. And then this is the controller. Okay, and then this is the summing junction where noise enter here. And then this is the plant or the process, the machine. Then enter, there is a disturbance also. Eh? And you can see that the output will be the output of the plant plus disturbance one and disturbance number two. So for a sample, examples, of open loop control system, okay, is a washing machine. Okay, what is the input of washing machine? Zairi Ilham, washing machine, automatic washing machine. Zairi,
yes, ejeling ah,
ada,
ah yes.
Do you have washing machine at home?
Ah yeah.
What is the input of washing machine?
Electric current.
Huh?
Sorry?
What is the input of washing machine?
Electric current.
Oh, input dia is dirty laundry. Dirty laundry. Sorry. And the output of washing machine?
Bersih. Clean laundry.
Clean laundry. Dirty laundry tu baju kotor lah.
Ayah, betul.
I cannot speak Malay because there are international students in my class.
Yes.
How, is there any international student in my class? Hello?
Yes, doctor.
Name?
Yes, doctor. Me, Zakaria.
Yes, doctor.
Zakaria. Zakaria.
Yeah.
From?
From Somalia.
Somalia. Number two, international student. Hello? Who else?
Me, doctor.
Who?
Abdurrahman.
Abdurrahman. Yes. Terminal? Egypt?
No, I'm from Afghanistan.
Afghanistan. Abdurrahman from Afghanistan. Okay, you speak Afghan, eh? Can you speak Arab?
I can speak Arabic also. Yes.
Okay, so you understand English, okay?
Yeah.
One from Somalia, one from Afghanistan. The other one?
I'm Fatur Zaki Hanafi, doctor, from Hanafi? Indonesia. Fatur Zaki Hanafi.
Hanafi, from Indonesia. Bapa bisa cakap Melayu? Jawa.
Boleh.
Jawa.
Boleh. Tak, doktor. Saya asal dari Padang, jadi saya bisa bahasa Minang.
Bahasa Minang. Okay. So I use English. Okay, yes. Number four, number three from Indonesia. Number four?
Soeb from Bangladesh, doctor.
From Bangladesh. Name?
Soeb.
Soeb from Bangladesh. Kia Munasin?
Yeah, Balawasi.
Balawasi, don't know about. Yeah. Number five?
Yeah, doctor.
International number five, who?
Nasser. Nasser Yusuf.
Nasser from?
Sudan.
Sudan. Sudan and Somali, two different, eh?
Yes.
Speak Arabic. Ahlan wa sahlan. Number five. Number six? Okay, only five, eh? So we have five international students, so you have to speak in English. Okay. Balkis? Balkis?
Yes, doctor, yes.
First example of open loop system is washing machine.
Yes.
Which input is dirty laundry, output is clean laundry.
Clean laundry.
Yeah. Then second example of open loop system is toaster. TOESTER. Toaster. So what is the input of toaster, Balkis?
Bread.
Huh?
Bread.
Bread. Two pieces of bread. And the output is?
Toasted bread.
Very simple. Okay. Okay. Very good. So, the third example. Rida Hadira.
Rida.
Example number three. Open loop system. Washing machine finish. Toaster finish.
Rice cooker.
Okay, rice cooker is considered as open loop system. So what is the input of rice cooker?
Rice.
No, not rice. Grain.
Yeah,
raw grain. Then you put water inside, then the output of the rice cooker is?
Rice.
It's a rice, okay? White rice, okay? White rice, okay? So in Malay, they are using white rice. In Arab, they are using Arab rice, okay? In Afghanistan and Bangladesh, they sometimes eat rice, sometimes they eat bread, okay? They eat both, okay? Right, so that is the open loop system. So now we go for closed loop control system, where the output signal of the closed loop control system is feedback. Okay, feedback to influence the control action and improve overall system performance. Okay, so the word feedback is very important. The difference between the actual and desired response will be used to determine the control action. So you can see here, just put one wire, okay, connect to the output, then goes to the transducer, send or sensor, and then goes to the summing junctions. Okay, so this summing junction will receive two signals. One is the input reference, and the other one from the output. So it will compare. Will compare the input and the output, and we will give you error. Okay, and this error will be received by the controller to improve the actions of the closed loop control system.
Excuse me, Prof.
Okay, question name?
Muhammad Ashraf.
From Malaysia?
Yeah, Malaysia.
Okay, alright, silakan.
Saya nak tanya tentang open loop control system, the disturbance.
Can you speak? Can you speak in English? Because we have five brothers international.
Sorry. Okay. I would like to ask you about the open loop control system. The block diagram from the disturbance. So disturbance. Okay.
Okay.
Where? Based on your example, where is the disturbance
come from?
Okay,
disturbance one and disturbance two is known as uncertainties, meaning that sometimes it comes, sometimes it didn't come. What is the sources of disturbance? Number one is your iPhone or your phone. Okay, so this is a microwave device which receive signals. Okay, so it can be one of the contribution towards the disturbance. A handphone. Number two is from the 3-pin plug at the wall. The 3-pin plug, you know, the one that you charge your phone or you charge your laptop. That plug pin have a 50 hertz sine wave because we are using an AC supply, 240 volt Malaysia. So there are 50 hertz sine wave, which also will be enter to the disturbance one or disturbance two. What else? From the rotating fan. Okay, if your machines you are doing in the lab, the fan is rotating, so it also contribute disturbance one and disturbance two. There is so many disturbance, okay, which we'll discuss along. All right?
Okay, Prof. So if you said so, can we just neglect the disturbance for generate the output in the open loop control system?
Meaning that how to because, eliminate?
Because you said that the disturbance is sometimes... they have, sometimes they doesn't have it. So yeah. Can we just neglect the disturbance to generate the output signal?
We can neglect, or we can Hello?
Yes, Prof, I'm here.
Can you hear me?
Yes, Prof, clear.
Okay. We can, it depends on, what do you call that? Depends on the signal to noise ratio, SNR. So you have a signals, you have a noise. So you measure your signal, for example, 5 volt, and then you measure your noise. Your noise may be 0.1 volt. So then find the ratio, signal to noise ratio, signal divided by noise. So 5 divided by 0.1, how much you get? 50 volt, meaning that your signals is bigger compared to your noise, which is 0.1 volt. So when your SNR is big, so you can ignore the noise or the disturbance. But if the signals you get is 1 volt and then the noise is 2 volt, so the ratio is 1 divided by 2. So 1 divided by 2 meaning that your SNR is very small, 0.5. meaning that your system have fully been disturbed by the noise and your measurement is not significant anymore. So you have to apply SNR, signal to noise ratio. Did I answer your question?
Yes, Prof. Thank you.
Yeah, okay. So closed loop control system, feedback control system, we often refer as CLCS, okay, the input transducer, convert the form of the input to the form used by the controller. The output transducer measures the output response and converts it into the form used by the controller from physical parameters to electrical signals. And the summing junction, which algebraically adds the signal from the input to the signal and the output, which compare together the positive and negative signal and then come up with an error at the output summing junction via the feedback path. So the output signal is subtracted from the input signals. So this one, we call it as the actuating signals. Okay, the actuating signals value is equal to the actual difference between the input and the output. So this is what we call as an error. So the closed loop compensates the disturbance. So when we apply closed loop or feedback, so we can compensate the disturbance. But if we don't apply closed loop, we apply open loop, so we cannot compensate disturbance. Okay, by measuring the output response, feeding that measurement back through the feedback path and compare the response with the input. So there is a difference between the two response. The system drives the plant via the actuating signals to make the correction. And there is no difference. The system does not drive the plant. So this already assumed that the system already fulfilled the desired response. Okay, any question before we go to the examples? This one. Is there any question?
Prof.
Yeah.
My name is Muhammad Ashraf again.
Yes.
I'm a little bit confused on the difference between open and close
okay. system. Okay.
Yeah.
So what are you confused on?
The example.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I can
example.
Yeah. Because I understand the block diagram, but I can't understand in our daily life which one is closed and which one is open.
Okay. Go here. Okay. Can you see my iPad? Can you see my iPad?
Yes, Prof.
Okay. You don't understand the open loop and closed loop examples.
Yes, Prof.
Open loop control system, closed loop control system.
Yes.
This one, washing machine. Number two, toaster. Can you see my handwriting?
Yes, Prof. Sorry, Prof. The screen is black.
Yeah. Tengah betul kan? Wi-Fi, okay. So, okay. Okay, can you see? Okay.
Yes.
Number one, sample of open loop air condition. Okay, so air condition, when you set at 25 Celsius in the room, so you start the aircon. So usually room temperature is about 29 to 30 Celsius. So when you set the remote control at 21 Celsius, so the aircon will blow cool air until the room reach at 21 Celsius. Then the aircon will off for a while because it's closed loop. You order the air condition via the remote control to maintain the temperature at 21 Celsius. Okay, number two is the car. Okay. So car, you can control by yourself, you see, it's a speed control. Okay, so in highway, 110 kilometer per hour, if more than 110, so you will get a love letter from the JPJ. You have to pay 300 RM. So you control the car by press the pedal of the accelerator in order to reach 110 kilometer. What else? Example of closed loop control system. What else?
Temperature of iron.
Iron also can. Iron. Iron. Temperature also. Sorry?
Heater.
What about the airplane?
Heater.
Heater. Yes, heater. Heater system. Heater system also can. Okay. So there's a lot of examples of control systems. Okay. So in the note side, yes.
I have a question. Kalau is washing machine, washing machine itu pun dia akan jadi open kan? Open.
Washing machine is an open loop control system. Cannot be closed loop. You do the setting, by entering the dirty laundry for a good washing machine. They will weigh the dirty laundry, how many kilos? Let's say 5 kilos. And then the washing machine automatically will use the amount of water, the amount of, the detergent to wash your dirty laundry, and then the antibacterial, and then the softener. So the machine will control this amount of three items to wash your 5 kilo dirty laundry. There is no closed loop.
What if we want to control the dryer to more high level, low level?
Your washing machine is with dryer. Most of the washing machine in Malaysia is just wash, dryer outside. But if you want to dry your laundry, you have to buy another one. We call it as dryer. So in that particular dryer, you can set the temperature for the dryer, okay? Usually not 100 Celsius, usually about 70 to 80 Celsius with 40 minutes of dryer. If you want to use the washing machine with the dryer, that will cost you a lot for one machine. It's about 5,000 RM.
So it cannot be two in one.
Yes, can be two in one, but the price is too expensive. Any question? Yes, Saya.
What about blender? Because we can control.
But blender is on and off.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. You put the raw materials inside your blender. Then you press on, so the DC motor will respond very fast to cut all the raw materials.
But we can control the speed. So it is open or closed.
Speed of the blender cannot be controlled. It's just only have one speed. Ini mesti tak pergi dapur budak ni. Blender satu speed je. Blender satu speed je. Mana ada dua speed?
Dia kan kita boleh control nak lumet sampai mana.
Bila dah hancur, pop off lah sendiri. Ini mesti tak pergi dapur budak ni. Okay, so kita berehat 10 minit. We take a rest for 10 minutes. Is it okay?
Okay, Prof.
10 minutes break. Huh?
Thank you, Prof.
Panadol can help relieve symptoms of pain and fever post COVID-19 vaccination. Take care.
Yeah.
Hello. Okay. Can we continue?
Yes.
Alright. 10 minit kan? Yang tadi. So we already tadi stop here. Okay, can you see the slide?
Yes,
Prof.
Okay. Okay, so example of a liquid level control system. Okay. So, yeah. Okay. The first 1 hour I'm using my iMac, and second hour I will use my iPad. Okay. So example of a control system, which is a liquid level control system. So this is a very common control system, okay, available in the industry. Okay, so sometimes we have a single tank, two tank, or couple tank, or three tanks, which have to we have to control the variables, which is known as the levels of the liquid. Okay, so usually in the petrochemical industry. Okay, so we have a input transducer, we have a controller, we have a pump, okay, actuator. So you know that actuator is motor, valve, and pump. Okay, it's considered as actuator element. Okay, so we need a pump in order to increase the level of the liquid, and then it goes to the plant, which is the liquid level plant. And this one, the output of the variables will be measured using a level sensor. So I believe you already learned measurements and instrumentations. So what is the name of a level sensor that you learned during last semester? Sensor for level measurements. Muhammad Daniel. Hello, Daniel.
Yes, doctor.
Give one sample of a level sensor that you know.
Water level sensor.
Level. Nama lah. Aduh, okay. Capacitance sensor, okay, is one of the popular sensor for level measurements. What else? Fatiha?
Ya, doktor.
Nama level sensor? Sample? Contoh?
Temperature?
Temperature tu ukur suhu lah. Ukur level.
Tak.
Tak kisahlah. Electrical boleh, mechanical boleh. What else? Huh? Yang ada kat toilet tu, in the toilet, when you flush, what is the name of that?
I don't know.
Huh? Ball floating, kan? Ball floating, a ball floating sensor tu, kan? It's mechanical. That is a mechanical sensor for liquid level. What else? Zulfikar.
Yes, doctor.
What else?
Float switch.
Float switch already there. Float switch. Float switch. Float switch. Actually, it's not float switch. We call it as a. Boleh lah, ball floating is considered as ball float switch. One is the conductor sensor.
Conductivity.
Conductivity, macam ni. Ni. So you have a liquid, okay. Okay. So in order to get this level, So you use a sensor here. Okay. So when the water increase, okay, water increase, and it goes to this one is what do you call that? Open circuit, but when the water touch the conductivity, so it will be a short circuit. Okay, so we'll close the valve. So it's a conductor. Both are conductors. Okay, to control the liquid levels, goes to the summing junction here. Okay, so this is a summing junction. So summing junction here, okay, is from the is a negative feedback, negative FB, okay, feedback, bukan Facebook, it's not Facebook. So this one is output, this one is the input. So the output will be the error, kan? Error. Which is I minus input, right? Okay. Then what will go to the controller, and after the controller, it goes to the actuator. So in reality, summing junction. Reality is what? In reality.
Operator?
Huh? Operator? Sorry? Operator? Okay. No, operator. Soibal? Summing junction in on paper or in drawing, we call it summing junction. In reality of life is what? Soibal? Soibal?
Yes, can you hear me?
Soibal from Afghanistan?
No, Bangladesh, doctor.
Oh, Bangladesh, okay.
Yeah.
Namki Saibal.
Yeah, so you can call me Sweb.
I can speak Bangladesh. I can speak.
Yeah.
Hijau ke nak kuning, boleh. So Saibal, what is summing junction?
Summing junction is the point where signals intersect with each other, right?
In reality.
Oh.
Is it a mouse or iPhone or oximeter? In reality, what is summing junction?
I'm not really sure about that.
Mm-hmm. Siapa nama budak ni? Ada gambar ni tapi tak ada nama. Siapa nama dia? Pakai tudung warna. Operational amplifier. Okay. That you learn in the electronics. Ni kan? So this is the output. This is the input, and this is the error. Okay, understand? Do you understand?
Yes, doctor.
Yes, doctor.
Okay, yes, prof.
So please take note that set point or input, this one is, we call it as SP. SP is the set point. Okay? Understand? SP is the set point. So in the class, I use duster. So here, I just use my hand. Okay? Use my pen. So I clean up everything. SP stands for set point. MV manipulated variable. Everybody say
manipulated variable.
CV.
Constant variable.
Control
variable.
Astaghfirullah.
Control variable. PV. What is PV?
Plan variable.
What is PV? Manipulated variable. Control variable. Set point. PV is
process variable.
Process variable.
Process.
Bagus. Sila ingat. Can you please remember? PV, MV, CV, and SP. Okay. Okay, understand? So, this is the difference between the output, the open loop and closed loop. Okay, for open loop controller, we have a driver, we have a motor. Just one way. Okay, one way ticket. But for closed loop, at the motor, we have a shaft encoder. What is the function of shaft encoder? What is shaft encoder?
To read motor speed.
To read motor speed.
To measure motor speed.
No. Motor speed is different. Henrietta?
Yes, bro.
What is shaft encoder?
It's attached to a shaft, a rotating shaft.
To measure position. Okay, I don't want to use shaft encoder. I use this one. So what is the function of tachometer? Farid Rizwan? I don't want to use shaft encoder. I use tachometer. So what tachometer do is to measure
the speed of
bagus speed kontam je bagus kamu dapat to measure speed. Okay, so in motor we have two control variable, okay, which is the position and the speed. Okay, understand? So the difference, what is the difference between open loop and closed loop? In terms of structure, open loop, very simple. Okay, so if you look here, very simple, 1, 2, 3. Only three device. closed loop, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 device. So meaning become complicated. Sensitive to parameter variations, open loop, very sensitive. Okay, very sensitive. And for closed loop is less sensitive because we have already the feedback to compensate the disturbance. Then disturbance, we cannot handle disturbance. Okay, cannot handle. The disturbance will enter to the system. Okay, and for closed loop, we can handle. The feedback will compensate all the disturbance. Applications, limited for open loop. For closed loop, the various system, a lot of system can apply open loop. In term of cost, open loop is more cheaper due to the simple structure, but for closed loop is expensive due to the complicated structure. Example of control system. So this is an example of control system. Power application in a dish type of antennas. Okay. If you go to Melaka, okay, there is a TM area, a remote, okay, where you can see the satellite dish antennas. Okay, so Astro is connected to this power amplification dish type antennas. Okay, is a parabolic. Okay, we also have in our school at WCC, Wireless Communication Center. Okay, so it varying from 8 to 30 meters. Very big, serving an earth station in the satellite communication network. Second one is a remote control robots in contaminated area. Oh, this one is a robot with 6 wheels, okay, which is using I think it's a solar, yeah? Okay, the solar panels, okay, and moving for the in the planet Mars, 1997. Solar power, 11.5 kilogram. This is similar to the weight of a road bike, okay, or a mountain bike, 11.5 kilo, with a speed of 0.4 meters per minute. Okay, it will a 6-wheel system, enable to climb over obstacle. And this one is very common for the thermostat or the air condition. Okay. For position to heat, okay, and then for rolling mill for paper productions, okay, to maintain the steel thickness despite the variations of disturbance. And this is the best one, high speed train system. Okay, in Japan, we have a such system. We call it as a Shinkansen. Okay, very fast. Train, which is using a magnetic levitation system. Okay, magnetic levitation system. Do you understand what is magnetic levitation system? Do you understand? Faham tak? What is the magnetic levitation system? Can you see my lamp over there? Can you see here?
Yes.
Can you see my lamp?
Yes.
So between the casing and the bulb, there is no wire. Okay. But if you put it on, it's off. Okay. It's off. But when I pull the bulb, okay. So it on. So no wire between the bulb and the body. It use the magnetic levitation system, okay, similar to the train as well. We have wheels for the high speed train, okay, and the path of the train, so it's not touched together, didn't touch, okay, So almost zero frictions, right? And then this move very fast. The speed is very fast, about 200 to 300 kilometers per hour. Okay. Any questions so far? Any questions so far?
Doctor, I have a question.
Yes, please.
So that means the train, what we call the train just now, the train, so the train is floating, right? All right.
The train is floating. Okay. Like my bulb now is floating. There is no wire between the body and the bulb. Miss Sarah. Ilya Maisara.
Yes, doctor.
Any question?
So far, no, doctor.
But I have question for you.
Okay, doctor.
Okay. My question is, what is the difference between sensors and transducer? What is the difference?
I'm not sure, doctor.
Kat rumah ke kat ETM?
Kat rumah.
Aisyah Solihah?
Yes, doctor.
Have any questions?
No question.
I have a question for you. What is the difference between sensors and transducer?
I'm not sure.
Not sure. Dah belajar lah ni. Azri, Azri Rukaini?
Yes, doctor.
What is the difference between sensor and transducer?
I don't know.
You don't know. You don't know. Zainal Arif?
Yes, doctor.
What is the difference between sensor and transducer?
Transducer will convert to electric signal. While sensor only detect physical.
Kemudian, Syuhada, same question. Syuhada, Syuhada Mahmud, tak datang. Nasir Ahmad,
yes, doktor.
What is the difference between sensors and transducers?
I think the difference is that the sensor will take the input and give the output, but the transducer will send but give the electrical input output.
Okay, so this is different between sensors and transducers. Sensing element only, sensors, they're just one piece of element that sends the physical signal and then voltage signals, that's it. After that, you need an amplifier to amplify the voltage signals. You need some conversions, okay? And when the circuit is associated with that sensing element, we call it as a transducer, okay? Do you understand? Know that?
Yes, prof.
Okay, so next is analysis and design objective of control system. So basically we have a control system is dynamic. It respond to the input by going through a transient phase before settling to the steady state phase. Okay, so in this transient response is the case when the plant is changing from one steady state to another. Okay, so dia macam like this. Okay, the response is go up and then go stable at stability, and then we call it as the steady state response. So this is a transient. Transient meaning the response start to catching up. Okay, catching up and then it goes to the steady state response. Steady state maknanya the response is steady, no change, no going up, no going down. Okay, steady at this levels and then it will end here. Okay, so this is your input command at number 4. And this is your, the blue one is the output. It goes to the steady state response. And the difference between input and output, we call it as a steady state error. Okay, this is a sample for elevator response. So our objective in control system is for satisfactory transient response, okay, where we fulfill the rise time, we fulfill the settling time, and we fulfill the overshoots. Satisfactory, we satisfied with the response, okay, meaning the fast or slow, fast or slow, okay. So we want very fast response. We don't want slow response, okay. And then stable system, so must be stable. No problem from the beginning to the end, from start to the destination, completed. Okay, so this is what we call as a stable. Okay, no unstable. We don't want unstable system. Then zero steady state error. Okay, ESS. Okay, the letter E subscript SS. E stands for error. SS stands for steady state. Okay, so this is the difference input and output. Okay, the difference between the input and output. So this is the leaf that I talking to you just now. Okay, so our objective is to reach at level number 8. Okay, so this is the building. So we have a type of response, satisfactory response. Okay, we have 4: over dam, critical dam, under dam, and undam. Okay, 4 type of response. So we want the fast response, okay, which is the under dam response. So the process is shown here, where we classify the control system based on the purpose of the system and the relevant class it belongs to. For example, for type of signals, we want a continuous control system or discrete control system. So in this subject, we will focus on the continuous control system. This one is not in our subject, it's in the final year subject. Okay. Then mathematical model, we will focus on the linear control system. Okay, so we are not focused on non-linear control system because the non-linear control system is in the master level. For control objective, we want a kinetic, which is the tracking control system, and process, which is the regulating control system. So the process will begin with mathematical modeling. Okay, so mathematical modeling, we can model the system using a first principle, which is a law of physics or circuit theory. Okay, using Ohm's law, using Kirchhoff voltage law, Kirchhoff current law. Or we can simply do experiment, collect the input and output data, then we construct the model. This one we call as the system identifications. Okay. So both can go along. So in analysis, we apply time domain and frequency domain. This subject, we focus on time domain. Frequency domain is in third year. Okay, next semester. Then for controllers, the design is based on the controller structure and controller type. This one also goes for the third year, next semester. Okay, so all have a design process. Step one, convert the system into a physical system using a modeling, then draw the block diagram, create the schematic, okay, find the mathematical model for the block diagram, reduce block diagram, then analyze and design a block diagram. For example, the antenna position control system. Okay, we have a potentiometer for position control. We have a motor and we have a gear, okay, to rotate all this. Then we have a differential amplifier and power amplifier so that we can measure the output of the positions and the desired angle that we want. Okay. And this is the schematics of the system where we will go detail in chapter 2, okay, for DC motor. And this antenna system started with a potentiometer, which is a sensor that detects displacement, then convert to voltage. Okay, so potentiometer is a sensor that detect the displacement, the distance, and then convert the distance to the voltage signal so that it can goes to the summing junction, and it will, this is the input signal and this is the output signals. So the output signal is in angular, okay, position angular, and will detect by potentiometer and convert to voltage, and we will compare the voltage of the input and voltage of the output to produce an error, okay, to the controller and then to the actuator, which is the motor, load and gears. And we need this model, okay, in order to describe the mathematical descriptions. So the mathematical descriptions here is the output divided by the input. Okay, so this one we call it as a transfer functions. Okay. So MATLAB is the software that we're going to use, okay, in this subject. We call it as a computer-aided control system design, or CACSD. MATLAB stands for Matrices Laboratory. So in order to use this, you must have a license. So you can download from UTM. It's free. It's already paid by UTM, 300,000 for the license. Okay, so it's not open source. Okay, it's a package with a license. We use MATLAB in UTM. In some overseas university, they are using Scilab. Scilab is another option of software, which is free, is an open source software from origin of France, okay? So you can download Scilab from internet, but it's not popular over here. Mathematica also can be used, but Mathematica is applied in Faculty of Science for Mathematics and Physics. We don't use Mathematica. And LabVIEW. So one, several of our lecturers also use LabVIEW. But LabVIEW also need a license in order to run it. So the best way is we use the MATLAB as the software. So MATLAB have a lot of toolbox, okay? So we use a control system toolbox, okay? And Simulink, which use the concept of drag and drop, and also have a oscilloscope, okay, to monitor the signals. So this MATLAB is a very important tool in control system because it relate to the program learning outcome, PO4, ability to work with modern instrumentation, software and hardware through applying MATLAB, which is the cost and learning outcome in analyze control system performance. Okay guys, any questions? We almost finished now, it's 3:46. Ada soalan? Kecuali tak faham. Any question?
Me.
Yeah, please.
For the MATLAB software, yes. We need to use the UTM VPN, right?
You have to enter myutm.my.
All right.
Okay, and then I'll show you lah. Eh. Oh, you got mainnya di body. Okay. Okay, I show to you how to enter participant share screen. Can you see?
Yes, bro.
My UTM kan? Dot my. Eh, sini pula. My UTM. Yeah, my UTM. Ni. So you have to use your ASIC account number, username and password, and you enter. Can you see?
Yes, Prof.
Wait, line very slow. Is in the portal UTM, myutm.my. So UTM Digital put in the software up download. Okay, so the line is slow now, you cannot enter, but I hope you can enter it later on. Okay, so use the UTM, but if you have the cracked version also can. Okay, considered halal lah. Eh? Susah sangat nak dapat kan? So you can use the cracked version, no problem. I think you already use during your second year, am I right?
Yes, bro.
Okay. Any question? Ada soalan? Aina? Ada soalan?
No, doctor.
Huh? Ada soalan?
Tak, saya ada soalan tapi tak berkenaan dengan kelas lah. Tapi tak apa. Itu tak apa.
Tak apalah. Boleh share. Tak ada masalah. Apa soalannya?
Kat mana doktor beli lampu kat belakang tu?
Oh, lampu kat belakang tu beli kat Shopee.
Oh, nak type.
Nanti I bagi link. I share the link.
Okay.
Dia jual dekat Batu Pahat je. Kat Batu Pahat dia jual kedai dia.
Okay.
Nanti I share the link.
Okay, thank you, Doctor.
Berminat, eh? Aina. Nurul Syakila?
Yes, I am.
Any question? What shall I call you? Nurul or Syakila?
Syakila. No question so far.
No question so far, eh? Do you understand what I teach you?
So far, so good.
So far, so good. Eh? So after you read my slide, you read the book chapter.
Yeah.
Yeah. After you read my slide, you read the book chapter given in the WhatsApp list. Okay. And then don't forget to look at the tutorial. Okay. Okay. So ini dia. Tadi siapa tu yang tanya tu?
Yes, saya, Prof.
Yep. Dah keluar dah. Yeah. My UTM. Tu. Pusat perisian. Nampak?
Nampak, Prof.
Nanti kalau you enter your essay, you will get different view lah. Pusat perisian, then MATLAB campus white license. Yeah. Ada kat sini. Can download from here. Antivirus also can. Microsoft 365. You want to use Microsoft Teams or whatever. Okay. So all in that. Okay, off microphone. Adik ramai tu. Masuk UTM cepat sikit. Susah nak belajar kat rumah. Okay, this is the tutorial for chapter 1. I think I will discuss on Monday. InsyaAllah. Okay. This tutorial is a collection from the test questions. Test 1 and test 1 questions. 6 or 5 years ago. So we can do together, insyaAllah. Boleh? Shakila?
Boleh, Doctor.
We do together lah. Huh? You buatlah dulu. Boleh? Then compare dengan jawapan I. Boleh?
Boleh.
InsyaAllah. Okay, any questions? So if no question, we end here. And I see you, insyaAllah, on Monday. Monday on the 25th of October. Okay?
Okay. Baik, Prof.
Okay. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Wal as innal insana lafi husn illa allazina amanu wa amilus solihat. Wa tawasaw bil haq wa tawasaw bis sabr. Subhanallahi wa bihamdi, subhanallahi wa bihamdika. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta wa astaghfiruka wa atubu ilaik. Assalamualaikum. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Prof.
Thank you, Prof.
Prof, where is attendance?
Attendance is I took by random. If I call your name, you respond, consider attend. If you keep quiet, consider not attend.
Bye-bye. Okay.